And we're back once again, ladies and gentlemen. So, we defeated Ridley after me doing my best giving the background story about how long he and Samus have been in conflict with one another. Anyways, so now that we got both major head honchos dealt with, it's time we go after Mother Brain herself. So, let's get to it. There's our exit. Let's see about getting some more missiles. How many super missiles did I have, anyways? Okay, so we're at max capacity for super missiles. All right. Get out of there. And we're done here. Excuse me. That's collapsed. All that does takes you directly above. Anyways. But we are not quite done yet. But, that's right, it's here. And we get the one weapon everyone talks about, the screw attack. Screw attack! For those of you who've watched Some Call Me Johnny back when he was Super Gaming Brothers, before it became the Let's Play channel, you know the reference. Now then. Ow. Alright. Very helpful. Boy, is it very helpful. Alright. Yep, it's here. Thank you. Samus there. That's what I wanted to do. Get that. Now then, let's get out of here. Okay. Let's go up to that one area. Faster way to get through this. There we go. There we go. Just in case. Now then. That's how powerful the screw attack is, folks. Okay, just screwed attack right between them, but whatever. This. Oh, come on. I got plenty of health. Ooh. Hang on, I know the trick. There we go. That's how you get that super missile. And we're done here. And let's get this missile upgraded somewhere. There it is. Now let's get going. We'll be right back. Ow. Alright, we're done here. Perfect. It's safe. Alright. Let's go. In the NES version, if you beat... Once you beat Ridley and Craig, strike the two statues, and it would raise a bridge for you to cross to get into Turian. And here we go. Those are the titular Metroids. Do not let those parasites latch onto you, because they will drain your life. Now then. Let's go. Those will help you restore your life and missiles, which is helpful because you're going to be putting them to use. Thank you. And it would be a good strategy to replenish your missiles. Ow! When they latch onto you, ow! Get the fuck off me! Thank you. Also, see if he can get some health. There we go. We're good. Well, almost. That damn L button, shoulder button will work. Ugh. Before we go down there, there we go. Wrong door. There we go. Hmm. Moving on. Thank you. Guess the green ones are more likely to give you stuff. Thank you. I could have grabbed that. There we go. That's it. Let's get out of here. Go, go, go. Come on. This is somewhat of a staple when it comes to Metroid, is a self-destruct sequence after taking out our final boss. Sometimes, the best thing to do is to take your time, especially on this. Ah! Is a remake, there's much more to it. And not just this segment here. Twist number one, in the original game, nobody knew Samus was a woman. Twist number two, yeah, back then, that revelation was a huge deal. So, Chun-Li, eat your heart out. Depending on how fast you beat the original game, it could be either in a leotard or a bikini. That ass. Anyways, don't judge me, you all did the same thing. So yeah. Because her shit got shot down, that contained her ability to transform back into her power suit, now she's just stuck in her Zero suit. This is the new part of the game, of the story, I should say. And a welcomed one, too. And we are back at Chozodia. Now, this ship, we will see it later again in Super Metroid, believe it or not. And what do I mean by that? Well, you'll see. Metal Gear Solid, anyone? Since we don't have missiles, there's no way we're gonna ever be able to open up any red doors. Out of curiosity, these type of save points restore everything. Your health, ammo, you name it. So, now we are going to go through the most nerve-wracking part of the game. And this is how we're going to conclude it, too. That first encounter, that's when the music just stays tense no matter what. After Metroid Fusion, believe it or not. So, those of you who played that game know exactly where I'm getting at. Hold it. There we go. Restore my health and save. Searchlights. Get up there. No! Why did I do that? Thank you. nicely done. Okay. Right where I need to be. Crouch. There we go. So we're getting much closer where we need to get to. Okay, those peepers. Do not let them see your leg hang out, because that will be your giveaway. Still. Oh, hell. This fucker will double back. Oh, fucker. Taken and moved by space pirate scum. Okay. And too bad he can't poke its eye out. nice. Alright. Now, don't worry, it's not gonna get to that last square. So... it's a matter of playing it safe. How about that? It's a rarity you're able to pull that off, but it's very doable nonetheless. Okay, so it's in here. So you don't have to deal with those fuckers trying to pursue you. Tense part is over, but we got one more thing we could do before we finish off this title. Well, a couple things, actually. First off, a flashback. A Chozodian god, I believe. Of legends. So here's how you clear this trial. Do not shoot at your image. When that symbol appears, hit it. You want to do it four times. Now it's going to start moving. That's two. That's three. One more time. Oh. Ow. And that symbol will show up for a very short time span. Ow. Got it. That's what we get. A new suit, and those three incompatible items are the plasma beam. The gravity suit, perfect for moving around water and lava. And last but not least, the space jump. All that's left is the one item that Space Pirate took. We'll be right back. got more super missiles. Now, let's conclude this title, shall we? Hang on. Up. What's up there? Sure, go ahead, alert your buddies. It's target practice. I don't care. Aha! Out. Charge of everything. Perfect. Just blast the hell out of it. Come on. The only way to take those out is just to screw attack right into them. that back up. There we go. All right, we're just about done. Yes, they're opened by exactly what you think they're opened by. Get a move on! Our ticket out of here, but first we need to figure out how to open that door. Talk about pathetically easy. Get a move on. Go. Devastating, are they? Oh, yeah. Now let's get out of here. Now, if you wanted to, you could go to where that corridor is that had a glass tube and just powerbomb, make your way out of the ship and go explore all the other areas in the game, but we're not gonna do that. We are, however. Alright, up above is our final area to go to. Okay. Ah, damn it. Jumped a little too late. Yeah, let's do this. I thought we'd start. Ah! Come on. Damn it. Come on. Ugh. That's better. Now, real quick. Ugh, come on. Oh. Let's see. Yep, I had to do some really tight space jumping. Our final boss. Sounds like something needs a serious oil job. Mecha Ridley. One interesting little fact about this dude is depending on how many items you get will determine how hard the boss fight will be. Like so. I think I'm like at 60 some odd percent item collection rate wise. Pay attention to the eye. Oh, haul ass like you've never hauled ass before. Come on. gotta go right now, gotta go, gotta go, gotta go right now. Get a move on. Almost out of here. Almost out of here. Now we gotta deal two of these fuckers. Come on. There we go. Open up. Mine! And that takes care of it.
Really?
What are you gonna accomplish there? Alright, champ, spin me out. Blah. See you in a few years. Yep. For a reimagining of a game that came out in 1986, this was pretty damn awesome. And this should be the standard of remake should be. Sakamoto Yoshio did take over was pretty much the head honcho of the franchise after the late Gunpei Yokoi, because this was part of the Nintendo R&D1 way back in the day that Yokoi was helm of. So yeah, this is one of two, well, both franchises helmed by Gunpei Yokoi, who was the father of the Game Boy. That was not helmed by Shigeru Miyamoto, believe it or not. And the last game Yokoi was producer in general, was Super Metroid, before his untimely death in 97. And bear in mind, at that time, that was when he had already left Nintendo, after the disastrous Virtual Boy. And interesting enough, for a game that originated in Japan, it's more popular here in America than it is in Japan. I'm not sure why exactly that is, but still. Though to be fair, it wasn't until Metroid Dread where it finally saw somewhat of a resurgence. Ah, Satoru Iwata, God rest your soul. Back to that mural. What's this? Aww, so cute. Alright, and depending on how fast you beat the game, as well as how the amount of items you clearly get. Yep, I just get Samus with her helmet off. One of the clear time bonus images is Samus in her Zero suit. Whereas back in the original NES game, it was her in a bikini, revealing that she was a woman. So, yes, you can say she is the first female protagonist in the history of video games. And for that, Samus, you rock, chick. And when we meet again, guys, we will be tackling Metroid Prime. But not the GameCube version, but the Trilogy version on the Nintendo Wii. So, as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic night. And see you, Space Cowgirl.